In my practice, I have been working with the city and everything that relates to it, from its people to its culture. And I was living in Mexico City for around 2 years in total, and it's definitely one of the most amazing and surprising places I've been. And in my way, I found Rosana Montiel, who's an architect, as well an artist, maybe as well a designer and a curator. And we related very well, and we started working together. And this exhibition is a bit the result of how we met. And I gave the name Look Closer to this exhibition because to really understand the city, we have to look closer and we have to analyze it more deeply than in the normal way of architects do. So, Look Closer is an exhibition that focuses on alternative ways of reading the city that maybe go a bit outside of the limits of the practice of the architect that is commonly represented by maps, by statistics, and that forgets that population is what makes a city a city, and that the city is much more than fluxes, people moving. It's about ethnic, it's about places, about space, and the relation of all of that. On the first moment, Rosana had a most common approach where she started analyzing the city in all its layers. And from there, she also started realizing there was quite some problems in the city that have been unseen. And she thought they were definitely a good point to start, because it was a problem that government and as well the population were just not looking at, and that's why she then developed the action of Se Ocupa. She found more than 100 buildings abandoned in just one avenue, and she decided to have a critical approach, maybe a curator approach, when she identified the best places for change. And and from there she started a completely new way of reading it and analyzing the city and proposing, not only by completely destroying everything and try to build something new, but to recycle and to work with what already exists. So following the idea of urban recycle, Rosana did a project where she identified on the tube lines around 22 abandoned buildings. They are government buildings, so she thought it would be a good idea to propose to rehabilitate them by use. So she did a proposal defending to reopen these infrastructures that are actually this amazing network. And through social activities, cultural activities, sports activities, and of course she then presented them in order to get it approved. Unfortunately, this was an approach that went through, and it happened, but it shows an intention. So from here she also, it was the moment where I started collaborating with Rosana, and we started to look at the city a bit closer. So we started analyzing its people, because to draw or to design a city in Europe or design a city in Latin America, we can't use the same formula. So culturally we are all different, and we can't just forget our differences and apply a common formula to all of them. So one of the projects that we started to work on was all the people that go through the city with these objects, and they have a different sound. They move in these sort of bike machines all through the city. very important to understand that from London we don't have these characters going to the city, and people don't have this appropriation of public space like they have in Mexico. So to design for a city like Mexico, one needs to understand it deeply and develop things for them. We also did a sound recording where we, well, each one of these characters, besides having a different object where they move, they also have a different sound. That sound many of the times are also related with the time of the day. So we know that the garbage man passes around 7 in the morning, and the man of the tamales passes at 8 in the evening. And all of this movement, all of these rhythms are Mexico and not somewhere else. So it's also, I think we should not forget that we can't design for something without contemplating all of it, and there is not just one formula. So that this exhibition is mainly about it, is that there are many ways to understand the city, much more than what architects understand. We also have a piece of João Bento, who's been in Mexico for a period of 2 months, I believe, and through his stay in Mexico, he did a lot of sound recording. And for this exhibition, I asked him if he could create a piece that would relate with the theme of reading the city. So he put it up a series of sounds that he captured all through the city in his stay, and we can listen. And that transports us back to Mexico and all its identity. So when we arrived to a point in the research that we knew that we wanted to work with people and with the population, we wanted to work with them in the construction of the living environment. And together with a group of artists, we developed 5 actions in Gustavo Madero, and they mainly reflected, or it was a way to relate with the community. We were not, our goal was not to have a final output of the project, but it was much more of the process that we were interested in. This specifically, it was the library. It was just a drawing with powder in a square, and after some days it was gone. But what interested us was to work with the children and women community, and that allowed.